Lauded to Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ. Welcome to this special live broadcast of the Holy Father Pope Francis, who is visiting Indonesia. I'm Father Paul Samasumo, and it is indeed a privilege to be with you on this second public function of Pope Francis in Indonesia. Special welcome to our partner television and radio broadcasters of EWN-TV, Catholic Faith Network in America, Luminous Radio, India, Shalom TV, India, and Sunday Shalom. Then there is Shalom World TV and Catholic TV. To those of you following us on YouTube, on our Vatican News website, social media stream, Facebook and others, those of you following on shortwave radio frequency, welcome to our Catholic national and diocesan radio stations, or whatever media you are catching this broadcast on. So glad you could be with us here for our special coverage of Pope Francis's visit to Indonesia. What you are seeing now is some people, young people, waiting for the Pope outside the main cathedral of Assumption here in Jakarta. Anytime now, the Holy Father, Pope Francis, should come through to the main Jakarta Catholic Cathedral of Our Lady of Assumption. He is meeting bishops of Indonesia, priests, deacons, consecrated people, seminarians, and catechists. The Pope has a busy day ahead of him on this apostolic visit that will see him also travel to Papua New Guinea, Timor-Leste, and Singapore. Already today, the Pope has met and addressed the country's political leadership and members of the diplomatic corps accredited to Indonesia. No doubt those of you that are watching us on TV, they have seen the beautiful edifice of the Catholic Cathedral of Our Lady of Assumption in Jakarta. It is the main place of worship for Catholics who live in Indonesia, in Jakarta. The cathedral is also the seat of the Archbishop of Jakarta, that is Cardinal Ignatius Suhario. The cathedral is situated right in the city center, and you can see it's imposing. It is an imposing structure indeed. Actually, the original church was inaugurated in February, way back in 1810. It burned down in July 1826, and the building definitely collapsed in 1890. The construction of the current structure with bricks and sandstones began immediately after, that is in the year 1891, and it was consecrated 10 years later in 1901. Everybody outside the cathedral expectantly waiting for the Holy Father to arrive and address the bishops, the priests, consecrated persons, seminarians, and catechists in the Cathedral of Our Lady of Assumption. I was just speaking about this beautiful structure that is the cathedral. It has always been at the risk of earthquakes, and so the current building, its ceiling is built of Indonesian teak wood, and the towers a mixture of stone and metal. Holy Father Pope Francis just arriving now. And you can see he is in good spirits, waving, and he called on to a mother of a child, who's blessed the child and given the mother the rosary. Another child being brought to Pope Francis, who is still in the car, just arrived in front of the cathedral, and definitely looking in good spirits. The mother there taking opportunity to do a selfie with the Pope, who is still in the car. Who would miss such a chance indeed? It's a chance in a lifetime. Christianity first arrived in Indonesia in the 7th century, but took hold only in the 16th century when several Catholic missionaries accompanied by the Portuguese started preaching in the archipelago. The Dutch, who expelled the Portuguese in 1605, introduced Calvinist Protestantism, and Catholicism was banned from the territory and was only reintroduced in 1806. In 1807, Catholic missionaries were able to return and continue the work that they had started. Holy Father Pope Francis now greeting those who are outside, the children who have lined up to greet him. I was just saying that actually out of the entire population, Catholicism is only 3%, but it is a very vibrant and a very strong Catholic community here in Indonesia. Pope Francis making his way to the entrance of the cathedral after greeting a number of people in the courtyard of the cathedral who have lined up to greet him. In traditional attire, very colorful and beautiful attire. Those of us following on radio can hear the sounds of the joy of the people who have come here to greet the Pope. Even if the event is really for the bishops, the clergy, the consecrated persons, and the catechists, still they couldn't keep them outside the fence of the small see-through fence of the church here, probably erected for the visit. They are outside there, getting a glimpse of the Pope and chanting words of welcome for the Holy Father, Pope Francis. I'll just let you listen to some of the atmosphere, the ambient atmosphere in the courtyard of the cathedral. Pope Francis now greeting the Cardinal of Jakarta, the bishops, the Bishop President, and receiving flowers from the children there, gifts, welcoming him into the Cathedral of Jakarta. Like they given him a picture there of the cathedral itself. Wasn't very clear the shot there. And now the Pope being wheeled into the cathedral, the parish priest of the cathedral giving him the cross to kiss. And then holy water to bless himself and bless the people. At the entrance, something that we always do when we enter a church, we bless ourselves with holy water. And inside this beautiful cathedral now, the religious, consecrated persons, members of the clergy can hardly contain their joy at seeing the Holy Father Pope Francis as he enters the cathedral. Eager, hands eager to shake him, touch him. Thank you. Francis has now taken his seat at the altar, and that was the entrance hymn. We're now going to listen to an address, welcome address, as the Holy Father begins this meeting. The Holy Father, the address of the President of the Indonesia Bishops' Conference.
We now welcome Bishop Antonius, the President of the Indonesian Bishops' Conference, who will deliver the opening speech.
Dear Holy Father, we love and admire you so much. We would like to express our gratitude to God and to your Holiness for showing us your paternal love and kindness by visiting us. The long journey must have been tiring, but we are joyful that you are here with us. You are always joyful, keep smiling to us, giving us blessing. Your presence brings hope not only for the Indonesian Catholic community, which consists of 37 dioceses and one military ordinary, but also for the diverse Indonesian nation. And thank you, Holy Father, this year you erect one of new Diocese of Labuan Bajo, which will be erected in next November. May your presence among us strengthen our faith to live according to God's command and the Church teaching in order to build the true fraternity, which is manifested through an attitude of compassion, especially towards those on the peripheries of society. It is our hope that following the theme of your apostolic visit, faith, fraternity, and compassion, we will increasingly seek an encounter with God that manifests the joy of the gospel, creates a culture of encounter in which we see others as a brother and sister, and restores the integrity of creation by listening to the cry of the poor and of the earth, our common home. We are also grateful for your charity as a shepherd who at times walked behind us to encourage us, at other times walked alongside to inspire us, and when necessary, walks in front of us to be an example of how we should journey toward holiness. Together with my brother bishop, who are celebrating 100 years of the Indonesian Catholic Bishop Conference and 10 Asian and Australian bishops here, as well as the clergy, consecrated men and women, catechists and other lay faithful, we ask for your prayers and blessing, so that we can walk together to build up the Synodal Church in Indonesia and the nation with faith, fraternity, and compassion. We will also always continue to pray for you, Most Holy Father. Thank you.
President of the Indonesia Bishops Conference, Antonio Subianto there. Welcome, the Holy Father.
The journey of the Catholic,
and now we have a testimony.
The story of synodality, strengthened by the Holy Spirit to walk among together the people of God with our neighbor. Father Maxi Unbria, the chair of Indonesian Diocesan Priest Community, and Sister Rina MC will share with us their story, how they live out their calling, and share the joy of the gospel in their mission in Indonesia. We welcome Father Maxi and Sister Rina MC.
The Mass of Ceremony is there, welcoming Father Maxi to share his testimony about how he lives his faith. He is the chairman of the Indonesia Federation of Diocesan Priests.
His Holiness Pope Francis, we, Unio Indonesia, Indonesian Federation of Diocesan Priests, today we are more than 2,600 priests would like to welcome His Holiness Pope Francis to Indonesia. We thank God that the visit of the Pope to Indonesia is a clear sign of the presence of divine joy to the Indonesian people and a blessing for us diocesan priests together with the priests of congregation and consecrated life who are walking hand in hand together serving the people of the particular church in Indonesia. Indonesia, as a pluralistic country in which diaspora churches live, has received attention and protection from both the Pope and the government. Unio Indonesia is ready to work together with Pope Francis, Nuncio, the Cardinal, the Bishop, the Priest, brother and sister of all congregation and the people of God in bringing joy and peace to the people of Indonesia and the world. With the one spirit, unity in diversity, to glorify God and serve the people. Thank you, His Holiness Pope Francis.
Reverend Father Max there, the chairman of the Indonesia Federation of Diocesan Priests, sharing with the Holy Father a testimony of the Indonesian Diocesan Priests and assuring the Holy Father that they are ready to work with him and work with the entire Universal Church in their faith. And now, Sister Rina Rosalina, on behalf of all consecrated men and women in Indonesia, I wish to express my deep gratitude for your visit, which inspires and strengthens our commitment to God. Despite the vast size of Indonesia, we consecrated men and women feel united in our work, supported by the Church and Indonesia bishops. The Lord has invited us to walk together on a pilgrimage and our responsibility to answer His invitation, not only in our local communities, congregations, and dioceses, but also with Your Holiness in communion with the Universal Church. Holy Father, we are always trying to learn from You, and unfortunately, due to distance and language barriers, sometimes we have difficulties studying the documents issued from Rome. Despite the efforts of our bishops, translations can take a long time, and even when they are completed, approval of these translated texts takes time in Rome. We are still waiting to be able to read in our national Bahasa Indonesia a number of your teachings. We bring to your attention, Holy Father, so that this distant country can be more perfectly united in harmony with your Universal Church, with the Universal Church. And finally, allow me to address a few words in Spanish to convey to you the affectionate greetings, especially on behalf of our poor clear missionary sisters of the Blessed Sacrament in Indonesia. We love you very much, and we are grateful to have such a close and pastoral Pope. Your Holiness, always count on our prayer and daily sacrifices. May God bless you. And the Holy Father making a comment that she knows how to command. Sister Arina Rosalina, poor Claire missionary of the Most Holy Sacrament, talking to Pope, giving a testament Pope Francis, and bringing out the challenges of the Indonesian church, especially translation of texts. Sometimes they take too long, and they would like to read them immediately, but they take too long. And also, she addressed him in Spanish, his own native language, to assure him of the poor Clare Missionary Sisters of the Blessed Sacrament's prayers for him. So we have had a testimony from a priest and a religious, and now we are going to have another one.
In the Catholic Church is always prominent from time to time, including in their involvement as the teacher of faith. The following two testimonies will be delivered by two catechists, Mr. Nicholas Wijaya and Mrs. Agnes Natalia, who have devoted themselves to teaching religious education in their dioceses and schools. We now welcome Mr. Nicholas and Mrs. Agnes.
Mrs. Agnes Natalia is a teacher at St. Ursula Elementary School in Jakarta. She's also a catechist at St. Mary the Virgin Queen Parish. Mr. Nicholas Wijaya is a Catholic religious teacher at Regina Pachis Senior High School
in
Bogor.
And it's really encouraging us catechists who work in this land of diversity. Thanks be to God, because the Holy Father always uses the term bridge as an analogy for the Church presence in society. Specifically in the encyclical Fratelli Tutti, the Holy Father says, like Our Lady, we must be a church that serves, goes out from the sacristy, and builds bridges of dialogue. As catechists, we constantly remind our students of the message of the encyclical. Pray for us, Holy Father, that as catechists we can be the bridge that unites many people to build other bridges, so that through the various bridges of dialogue, we can always present the face of Christ with compassion.
That was the testimony of Mr. Nicholas Vijaya, a Catholic religious teacher at Regina Pachi Senior High School in Bogor. He's a member of the Catechetical Commission, saying something to the Holy Father there that we couldn't catch. There's going to be another testimony from Miss Agnes Natalia. She's a teacher at St. Ursula Elementary.
Allow me to share my feelings. Pope Francis is a man of great concern for the preservation of nature and for the small, the poor, the weak, the marginalized, and the disabled. His concern for nature and the poor can be seen in the statement he made during the weekly audience in St. Peter's Square on Wednesday, June 5, 2013, to mark the UN World Environment Day. He said, wasting food is like stealing food from the table of the poor and hungry. These words are similar to his first apostolic encyclical, Laudato Si, on May 24, 2015, concerning about Mother Earth as a common home. He also showed great concern for the disabled by saying that everyone is beautiful in the eyes of God. He made the statement when he was welcoming children with autism spectrum disorders from the Sonnenschein Ambulatorium in St. Pölten, Austria, who came to the Vatican on Monday, September 21st, 2020. He truly represented Saint Francis of Assisi, whom he took as his papal patronym in action. Thank you, Father.
Thank you. Diga que yo soy San Francisco de Assisi. Coraggiosa questa, ma forse assomiglio al lupo meglio, no?
The Holy Father, exchanging a few words there. My name is Pope Francis of Assisi, and she's very courageous.
La Chiesa,
the Church.
Dobbiamo pensare questo.
We must think.
La Chiesa la portano avanti.
The Church takes is taken forward or is advanced by catechists. It's the catechists who are always in front of everything. Then the nuns come after. Then the priests come, bishops. But the bishops are always the first on the front line. They are the force of the Church. Once in one of these trips in Africa, the president of a republic said to me, she wants to run away. The catechist, Miss Natalia, is standing right next to the Pope. The president said to me, he was baptized by his father, who was a catechist. The faith is transmitted at home. And the catechists, together with mothers and women, they are the ones that carry forward the faith. Thank you to all the catechists. They are really great. The Holy Father, spontaneously speaking there after listening to Miss Natalia's testimony and encouraging her, and she was standing right there, an unexpected impromptu gesture from the Holy Father. And now we wait to listen to the Holy Father, what he has to say to the religious the bishops here. A very touching brief word there from the Holy Father, who listened to Miss Natalia there and telling us a story about a president of a country in Africa who told him was baptized by his father, who was a catechist. Dear brothers and sisters, good evening. There are cardinals here, bishops, there are priests, there are sisters, there are the laity, and their children. But we are all brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter, Pope, Cardinal, everyone has their assignment to make the faith grow. I greet the cardinal, bishops, priests, deacons, consecrated men and women, seminarians, and catechists who are present. How many seminarians are here? Please raise your hands. They are hidden. They are up there on the balcony, and the Pope waves to the seminarians. I thank you, President of the Bishops' Conference, for his words, as well as the brothers and sisters who share their testimonies with us. As you know, the motto chosen for this apostolic visit is faith, fraternity, compassion. I think these three virtues express well both the journey as a church and also your character as a people who are ethnically and culturally diverse. But at the same time, you are characterized by an innate striving for unity and peaceful coexistence, as witnessed by the traditional principle of Pancasila. I would like now to reflect with you on these three words.
Sini saya melihat ada kardinal, uskup, pastor, romo, suster, awam, yang besar dan yang kecil, semuanya hadir di sini. Tidak merupakan sebuah perbedaan di antara kita. Semua kita adalah saudara, dan saya diberikan tanggung jawab untuk menumbuh dan mengembangkan Gereja Katolik. Saya ingin menyapa semua yang hadir di sini. Saya juga ingin berterima kasih kepada Ketua Konferensi Wali Gereja Indonesia untuk sambutannya. Demikian juga kepada saudara dan saudari kita yang telah membagikan kesaksiannya dengan kita. Seperti yang Anda sekalian ketahui, moto yang dipilih untuk kunjungan apostolik ini adalah iman, persaudaraan, dan bela rasa. Saya pikir, ketiga keutamaan ini mengungkapkan dengan baik perjalanan Anda sebagai sebuah gereja dan karakter Anda sebagai sebuah bangsa yang secara etnik dan budaya berbeda. Pada saat yang sama, Anda sekalian dicirikan oleh sebuah pergumulan yang dalam untuk mewujudkan persatuan dan kehidupan bersama yang bersatu dan damai, seperti yang dicerminkan oleh prinsip-prinsip tradisional Pancasila. Sekarang saya ingin bersama Anda merefleksikan tentang tiga kata tersebut.
The first word is faith. Indonesia is a large country with many natural riches in terms of plants and wildlife, energy sources, raw material, and so on. If viewed superficially, such great wealth could be a reason for pride or arrogance. But when considered with an open mind and heart, this wealth can instead be a reminder of God, of His presence in the cosmos and in our lives, as sacred scripture teaches us. I had forgotten this. The classes. The Holy Father wearing his glasses. Indeed, the Lord who gives us all this, there is not an inch of all the marvelous Indonesia territory, nor a moment in the lives of the millions of inhabitants that is not a gift from God, a sign of His gratuitous and everlasting love as Father. Looking at all we have been given with humble eyes of children helps us to believe, to recognize ourselves as small and beloved, and to cultivate feelings of gratitude and responsibility. Agnes talked here about this when inviting us to live our relationship with creation and with our brothers and sisters, especially the most needy, through a personal and communal lifestyle marked by respect, civility, and humanity, together with sobriety and Franciscan charity.
Dengan banyak kekayaan alam, terutama marga dan satwa, sumber daya energi, bahan baku, dan seterusnya. Kalau dilihat secara sepintas, kekayaan yang begitu besar ini dapat menjadi alasan untuk menjadi sombong atau angku. Tetapi kalau dilihat dengan pikiran dan hati yang terbuka, kekayaan ini sebaliknya dapat menjadi pengingat akan Allah, akan kehadirannya di alam semesta dan dalam hidup kita, seperti yang diajarkan kitab suci pada kita. Sesungguhnya Tuhanlah yang memberikan semua ini kepada kita. Tidak ada sejengkal pun dari wilayah Indonesia yang menakjubkan ini, dan tidak ada satu momen pun dalam kehidupan jutaan penduduknya yang bukan merupakan anugerah dari Allah. Sebuah tanda akan kasih-Nya yang cuma-cuma dan abadi sebagai Bapa. Melihat semua yang telah diberikan pada kita dengan mata anak-anak yang ugah hari, membantu kita untuk percaya, untuk mengenal diri kita sendiri sebagai insan kecil dan dikasihi, dan untuk memelihara rasa syukur dan tanggung jawab. Tadi Agnes berbicara tentang ini ketika ia mengundang kita untuk menjalin relasi kita dengan alam ciptaan dan dengan saudara dan saudari kita, khususnya dengan mereka yang paling membutuhkan, melalui gaya hidup pribadi dan komunal yang ditandai oleh sikap menghormati, keadapan dan rasa perikemanusiaan, bersamaan dengan ketenteraman dan kasih Franciscan.
After faith, the second word in the motto is fraternity. A 20th century poet used a very beautiful expression to describe this attitude. She wrote that being brothers and sisters means loving each other by recognizing each other as different as two drops of water. This is beautiful. That expression captures perfectly. There are no two drops of water that are alike, nor two brothers or sisters, nor even twins, not even identical twins. Living out our fraternity, then, means welcoming each other, recognizing each other as equal in diversity.
Seorang penyair abad 20 menggunakan sebuah ungkapan yang sangat indah untuk menggambarkan sikap ini. Seorang penyair, dia menulis bahwa menjadi saudara dan saudari artinya mencintai satu sama lain dengan mengakui bahwa masing-masing pribadi sama berbedanya seperti dua tetes air. Nulla due volte accade, itu dalam buku tersebut.
Anche questo
è this too is a value dear to the Indonesian Church and is made manifest through the openness which you address the various internal and external realities encountered on a cultural, ethnic, and social as religious level. In particular, your local church values contribution of all and generously offers assistance to every setting. This is important, brothers and sisters, because proclaiming the gospel does not mean imposing our faith or placing it in opposition to that of others. It does not mean proselytizing, but it means giving. It is always with great respect. And in this, I invite you to continue always being open and friends to all. I like this very much. Hand in hand. We should go hand in hand together. As Father Maxi said, we are prophets, and we must continue together. And I would like to say something. Do you know who is the most important person? Who does most of the division, dividing? The greatest person who divides all, Jesus brings together, is the devil. Be careful. The Pope inviting the tradition, the translation in Bahasa.
Tidak ada dua tetes air yang sama. Tidak juga dua saudara atau saudari, bahkan saudara kembar pun sama sekali tidak identik. Menghidupi persaudaraan karenanya berarti menyambut satu sama lain, mengakui satu sama lain sebagai sederajat di dalam perbedaan. Nilai ini pun akrab dengan Gereja Indonesia dan diperlihatkan melalui keterbukaan yang dengannya kalian semua menunjukkan beragam kenyataan dari dalam dan luar yang dijumpai pada tingkatan budaya, etnik, sosial, dan agama. Secara khusus, gereja setempat menghargai sumbangsi dari semua orang dan dengan murah hati menawarkan bantuan dalam setiap situasi. Ini penting, karena mewartakan Injil bukan berarti memaksakan iman kita untuk mempertentangkannya atau mempertentangkannya dengan orang lain, iman orang lain. Dilarang untuk melakukan proselitisme. Selalu dengan sikap penghargaan yang besar dan kasih sayang persaudaraan untuk semua orang. Ya, saya terkesan dengan satu sikap, yaitu saling bergandengan tangan, seperti yang tadi diungkapkan oleh Romo Maxi. Nabi-nabi persatuan di dalam dunia ketika tendensi untuk memecah belah, memaksa dan memprovokasi satu sama lain, kelihatannya terus-menerus meningkat. Dan satu hal yang beliau tambahkan secara spontan, kamu tahu apa yang mempunyai kepentingan atau apa yang memecah belahkan, apa yang meruntuhkan. Semua itu tentu saja adalah kerja setan. Jadi berhati-hati.
Cosa ti ha fatto ridere?
What has made you laugh? The translator was trying to say some of the things the Pope said of CAP. It is important to try to reach everyone, as Sister Rina reminded us in her testimony. When she spoke of the church, importance of translating in Bahasa Indonesia in order to make the text accessible to many people as possible. Nicholas also pointed out the need to reach everyone, describing the mission of the catechists with the image of a bridge. This struck me and made me think of a wonderful vision in the great Indonesia archipelago of thousands of bridges of the heart uniting all the islands, and even more, millions of such building of bridges uniting all the people who live there. Another beautiful image of fraternity would be an immense tapestry of threads of love that cross the sea, across barriers, embracing all diversity, making everyone one heart and one soul. The language of the heart is very important.
Kita tadi sudah diingatkan oleh Suster Rina, penting untuk mencoba menjangkau setiap orang. Mengenai hal ini, diharapkan bahwa tidak hanya teks-teks sabda Allah, tapi juga ajaran-ajaran gereja diterjemahkan ke dalam bahasa Indonesia agar dapat dijangkau oleh sebanyak mungkin orang. Nicholas juga menunjukkan perlunya menjangkau setiap orang, seraya melukiskan misi seorang katekis dengan perumpamaan jembatan yang menyatukan. Hal ini menyentuh saya dan membuat saya berpikir tentang visi indah di dalam negara kepulauan Indonesia yang luas, yang terdiri dari ribuan jembatan hati yang menyatukan semua pulau, dan bahkan jutaan lagi jembatan yang menyatukan semua orang yang hidup di sana. Perumpamaan indah lainnya tentang persaudaraan adalah sebuah permadani besar dari benang cinta yang melintasi lautan, mengatasi rintangan-rintangan, dan merangkul semua perbedaan, membuat semua orang menjadi sehati dan sejiwa. Beliau tekankan jembatan kasih.
We come now to the third word, compassion, which is very close to fraternity. We know that compassion does not compassion is about is more than just sharing sentiments. As we know, compassion does not consist only giving alms or to needy brothers and sisters while looking down on them from a tower to our own security, of our own security and success. On the contrary, it consists, compassion consists of drawing us close to the one, to one another, removing everything that can prevent us from stooping down to touch those on the ground, lifting them up and giving them hope.
Sekarang kita sampai pada kata ketiga, bela rasa, yang sangat terkait erat dengan persaudaraan. Kita tahu bahwa bela rasa tidak dibatasi saja pada memberi sedekah kepada saudara dan saudari yang membutuhkan, sambil memandang rendah mereka dari menara rasa aman dan keberhasilan kita. Sebaliknya, bela rasa berarti mendekatkan kita satu dengan yang lain, menghapuskan segala sesuatu yang menghalangi kita untuk turun menyentuh mereka yang ada di bawah, mengangkat mereka dan memberikan mereka harapan. Bandingkan Fratelli Tutti 70. Terlebih, bela rasa berarti merangkul mimpi dan hasrat mereka akan kebebasan dan keadilan, memelihara mereka, mendukung mereka sambil melibatkan orang lain, memperluas jaring dan batas-batasan untuk menciptakan kekuatan kasih yang luas dan besar.
This is important. We need to touch poverty. When I wrong someone, I always ask, or when I give confession, I always ask people, do you give to the poor? When you give to the poor, do you touch the people you are giving? Do you touch their hands? Do you look at the hands of those you are helping, or you help them from afar?
Questa è una cosa che dobbiamo imparare tutti.
This is something that we all need to learn. When we are giving alms, giving compassion means to accompany and to be with the person who is suffering, to embrace them, not to give from afar. Moreover, it means embracing the dreams and desires for freedom and justice, taking care of them, supporting them, while also involving others, widening the net and the boundaries to create a great expansive dynamism of charity. This does not mean you are a communist. It means charity. It means love.
Adalah penting untuk menyentuh orang-orang kecil atau kaum miskin. Ketika saya mendengarkan pengakuan, saya biasanya bertanya kepada orang, apakah dia atau orang itu pernah memberikan sedekah kepada orang miskin? Itu pertanyaan yang pertama. Lalu yang kedua, pertanyaannya, apakah dia juga menyentuh tangan orang yang meminta? Beliau ingin mengatakan bahwa kita tidak hanya memberi, tetapi juga bersentuhan langsung dengan yang meminta, kaum miskin, memandang ke dalam mata mereka. Itulah yang dikatakan tadi sebagai mengembangkan jaringan kasih.
There are those who are afraid of compassion. They are just afraid of compassion because they consider it a weakness. Suffering with others is seen as a weakness. Instead, they champion, as it were, a virtue of shrewdness of those who serve their own interests by keeping distance from everyone, by not letting themselves be touched by anything or anyone, thus thinking they are more lucid and free in achieving their goals. Unfortunately, where in Buenos Aires, I met many people who were very rich, but always were taking more money. And this person I knew died and left big inheritance. Do you know what jokes people used to say?
Non hanno potuto chiudere la bara. Voleva prendersene tutto.
They say that he couldn't close the casket because he wanted to take with him the riches that he had on earth.
Bela rasa, karena mereka menganggapnya sebuah kelemahan. Sebaliknya, mereka menjunjung tinggi seakan-akan sebuah keutamaan kelicikan mereka yang melayani kepentingan diri mereka sendiri dengan menjaga jarak dari semua orang dan tidak membiarkan diri mereka disentuh oleh apapun dan oleh siapapun. Jadi mereka berpikir bahwa mereka lebih cerdas dan bebas dalam mencapai tujuan-tujuan mereka. Ini adalah cara yang salah dalam melihat realitas. Beliau memberikan sebuah contoh. Di Argentina, di Buenos Aires, beliau mengenal seorang yang kaya, yang selalu ingin menerima dari orang, mengeruk kekayaan melalui orang lain. Lalu orang-orang sekitarnya membuat sebuah lelucon, mengatakan, anak yang malang, orang yang malang, karena dia begitu ingin mendapat dari yang lain, tetapi kemudian tidak bisa menutup peti jenazahnya sendiri.
Do not forget one thing. The devil enters through the pocket, always.
È vero.
Apakah anda percaya?
Questo di avere delle ricchezze come sicurezza.
This is a false way of looking at reality, wanting to have more riches. What keeps the world going is not the calculations or self-interest, which generally end up destroying creation and dividing communities, but offering charity to others. Compassion does not cloud the true vision of life. On the contrary, it makes us see things better in light of love. We see things better with the eyes of the heart.
Dunia bergerak maju bukanlah perhitungan kepentingan pribadi yang umumnya berujung pada kerusakan ciptaan dan pemecahbelahan komunitas, tetapi mempersembahkan kasih kepada sesama. Bela rasa tidak menggelapkan visi kehidupan yang sejati. Sebaliknya, bela rasa membuat kita mampu melihat pelbagai hal lebih baik dalam terang kasih. Secara spontan beliau mengatakan, kita melihat realitas dengan baik hanya dengan mata hati.
E vorrei ripeterlo, per favore.
I would like to repeat something. Please be careful. Do not forget. The devil enters through the pocket.
Tolong, jangan lupa. Setan selalu ada di dalam saku.
In proposito, il portale di questa cattedrale nella sua architettura.
In this regard, the architecture of the cathedral's main entrance, with its Marian focus, sums up very well what we have said. At the center of the pointed arch is a pillar on which there is a statue of the Virgin Mary. It thus shows us that the Mother of God is above all the model of faith, but she also symbolically supports the entire edifice of the Church through her humble yes to God's plan. Yet, the pillar represents Christ and the humble woman standing on that pillar seemingly bears with him the weight of the whole building, as if to say, in the end, the humble labor and ingenuity cannot support itself. Mary, therefore, appears as an image of fraternity, a gesture of welcome in the middle of the main entrance of all those who wish to enter. She is the mother that embraces. Finally, she is also an icon of compassion, watching over and protecting God's people who wish with their joys and sorrows, labors and hopes, gather in the Father's house. She is the mother of compassion.
Berkaitan dengan ini, kita melihat arsitektur pintu masuk utama katedral ini dengan titik berat pada corak Marianya, merangkum dengan baik apa yang telah kita katakan tadi. Di pusat lengkungan yang menunjuk ke atas, terdapat pilar yang di atasnya ada patung perawan Maria. Hal ini menunjukkan kepada kita bahwa Bunda Allah di atas segala-galanya adalah teladan iman. Tetapi dia juga secara simbolis menopang seluruh bangunan gereja melalui ya-nya yang sahaja terhadap rencana Allah. Tubuhnya yang rapuh, yang diletakkan di atas pilar, di atas batu wadas yang adalah Kristus sendiri, seolah memikul beban seluruh bangunan bersamanya, seolah-olah mau mengatakan pada akhirnya bahwa karya manusia dan kecerdasan manusia tidak dapat mendukung dirinya sendiri. Oleh karena itu, Maria dalam hal ini tampil sebagai citra persaudaraan, sebagai sikap yang menyambut di tengah pintu masuk utama kepada mereka semua yang ingin masuk. Akhirnya Bunda Maria juga merupakan sebuah ikon bela rasa yang mengawasi dan melindungi umat Allah yang dalam suka dan duka mereka bekerja dan berharap yang berkumpul di rumah Bapa.
Dear brothers and sisters, I would like to conclude these reflections by respecting what Sister St. John Paul II said, addressing the bishops, clergy, and religious during his visit here several decades ago. Quoting from the Psalms, Laetentu insule multae, let the many islands rejoice. He invited those listening to put into practice by bearing witness to the joy of the resurrection and in giving your life so that even the most distant islands may rejoice at hearing the gospel of which you are the authentic preachers, teachers, and witnesses. I too renew this exhortation and encourage you to continue your mission by being strong in faith, open to all in fraternity, and close to one another in compassion. Strong and open to welcome everyone. For me, the story of the gospel, when those who were invited to the wedding didn't want to go. What did the Lord do? He was not discouraged. He sent his people to the streets, bring everyone new into the wedding feast.
Cosa tanto bella che andare avanti con la fratellanza.
Let us go forward with fraternity and compassion and unity.
Penso io a tante isole, no?
I think of the many islands.
Che il Signore dice alla gente buona, a voi.
And the Lord says, come. Even those from the distant islands come, even the bad and the good, he invites them.
Saya ingin menutup refleksi ini dengan mengulangi apa yang Santo Yohanes Paulus II katakan ketika memberikan sambutan kepada para uskup, klerus, dan biarawan-biarawati selama kunjungannya di sini beberapa puluh tahun yang lalu. Mengutip ayat berikut ini dari kitab Mazmur, Mazmur 97 ayat 1, Letentur insule multe, yang berarti, biarlah banyak pulau bersuka cita. Beliau mengundang para pendengarnya untuk melaksanakannya dengan menjadi saksi sukacita kebangkitan dan melalui pemberian diri demikian, sehingga bahkan pulau-pulau yang paling jauh pun dapat bersuka cita. Karena mendengar Injil yang mana Anda semua adalah para pewarta, para guru, dan saksi-saksi yang otentik. Saya juga ingin membaharui ajakan ini dan saya mendorong Anda untuk meneruskan misi Anda dengan menjadi kuat dalam iman, terbuka kepada semua dalam persaudaraan, dan dekat dengan satu dengan yang lain dalam bela rasa. Saya memberkati Anda dan berterima kasih kepada Anda semua atas semua hal baik yang Anda lakukan pada hari ini. Beliau menekankan kembali pentingnya ketiga nilai yang dibawa sebagai moto dan menekankan kembali sikap inklusivitas semua. Nilai-nilai yang beliau tekankan lagi, persaudaraan, bela rasa, ya, semua karena di sini banyak pulau.
Anche io vi rinnovo questa esortazione.
I would like to renew this exhortation and encourage you to continue your mission by being strong in faith, open to all in fraternity, and close to one another in compassion. Faith, fraternity, and compassion. Three words that I leave with you. Think about them later. Faith, fraternity, and compassion. I bless you and thank you all for all the many good things you do each day in this lovely island. I'll pray for you. I pray and ask you please to pray for me. And be pray in favor and not against.
Jadi sebenarnya sudah diterjemahkan tadi, beliau membaharui ajakannya dengan menekankan tiga hal sebagai moto kunjungan beliau pada hari ini. Secara khusus beliau tekankan kuat dalam iman, terbuka kepada semua dalam persaudaraan, dan dekat dengan satu sama lain dalam sikap atau bela rasa. Jadi beliau tekankan lagi, iman, persaudaraan, dan bela rasa. Ketiga hal ini ingin saya tinggalkan untuk Anda kalian semua. Terima kasih untuk segala sesuatu, semua kerja yang Anda lakukan, dan jangan lupa berdoa untuk saya. Tetapi berdoa dengan senang hati. Ya.
And that is the Holy Father's address to the bishops, religious, and catechists, seminarians here in the Cathedral of the Assumption in Jakarta, Indonesia. A very lively Holy Father there, making impromptu remarks as well. And the Master of Ceremonies now inviting to pray the Holy Mary. Rather the Hail Mary.
Ave Maria, ognuno nella propria lingua. Ave Maria.
And the Pope inviting everyone to praying the Hail Mary in their own language.
Tu sei benedetta fra le donne e benedetto il frutto di tuo. Santa Maria, Madre, prega per noi peccatori, adesso e l'ora della nostra morte. Amen. Domino vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Et cum omnium sum
benedictum. Aiuterium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terra.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater et Filius, Spiritus Sanctus.
And so with that blessing, concluding this meeting.
Congregations are allowed to sit. As the last session of our meeting, there will be two photo sessions of the Holy Fathers with the bishops attending this event. In the first session, we would like to invite the President Bishops of the Indonesian Bishop Conference and the Emeritus Bishop of Indonesia and some other bishops who have been assigned for the photo session.
So the Master of Ceremonies is there, inviting for the bishops for a photo session with the Holy Father in the Cathedral after he just addressed the bishops, lay, catechists, the priests, consecrated men and women.
Thank you.
before the bishops. The second session, we would like to take, we would like to invite all the bishops coming from Asia and Australia and the rest of the bishops to come forward and take a photo with the Holy Father.
And during this rest, the Holy Father applauding Indonesia for religious tolerance. And in fact, that's one of the key elements of Pope Francis's visit. He would like to highlight and encourage that reputation of Indonesia as a country of religious intolerance. Just in case you are listening from home on your radio, what is happening right now is the Holy Father is taking pictures with the bishops. First, he just finished a round of pictures with bishops from Indonesia, and now pictures with the bishops who have come from other Asian countries and Australia for this visit of the Holy Father.
The Holy Father will leave the church, the cathedral, and heading to Graha Bermuda. We express our sincere gratitude for his visit, prayers, and encouraging words given to us. Let us now stand and give love.
Pope Francis now leaving the cathedral, and the Master of Ceremonies inviting everybody to be upstanding as the Holy Father, when he will chant, leaves the cathedral to the next
Bapak
event,
Ibu, tetap di
the Scholars
ya,
Operante event,
in the
where the Holy Father will meet
a
number of young people who belong to this international organization or movement of extensive education, which he himself started in Buenos Aires in the year 2001. We hope you'll be able to join us. This event should be starting shortly after this one. You'll be able to join us for that event, Pope Francis meeting the young people. As we saw at the beginning, when the Holy Father was coming in, the Pope greeting, many, many hands outstretched to him as he's going outside the cathedral. And right now, just having a word with one of the assistants there who are on his entourage. And we saw the Holy Father really linking up the theme, the motto of this visit in Indonesia, faith. The motto of the apostolic visit to Indonesia, he managed to link every word in his address to the religious, the bishops, and all those, the Catechists as well. very much in high spirits, Pope Francis, today. And now some of the children of the cathedral greeting the Holy Father, Pope Francis, as he is leaving and making his way to the Grab Pemuda, which is where the meeting of the Scholars of Orantes will happen. So with those pictures of Pope Francis greeting the children, my name is Father Paul Samasumo, and that brings us to the end of our extended coverage of Pope Francis in Indonesia. Join us in the next event. Laudato Jesus Christus, praise be Jesus Christ.